Guys, welcome to Waste Not Wednesday, where we go live every Wednesday at 10 a.m. Mountain Time, and we take junk that we got for free or next to free, and we turn it into things we sell or we use at home decor in our house.
There is a story behind this junk. This is not just run-of-the-mill scrap wood.
This is tip wood.
We were at the dump yesterday.
Otherwise known as the tip, you're from the UK.
We decided we wanted to just start calling it the tip. Yeah, it sounds tip, so much cooler than getting something from the dump.
I went to the tip. Sounds better than I went to the dump, right?
So we were there throwing away all of the little unusable scraps and things from putting the siding on the house. There was a lot I saved. Don't worry, we got projects coming with that too.
Projects for days.
But there was some that was just like weird cut angles and small pieces and strips. We just had to throw it away. It was unusable. And this was sitting there over in a big pile of other lumber. And Jamie's like, that's like a $20 board sitting over there.
I wanted to save all the wood, but you're not supposed to pick from the tip.
She was going to get me kicked out. Like,
I can't get kicked out there.
They'll pull the license plate off your truck and be like, no, you can't come back here.
So I pulled one board. It was cracked all the way through. So I put it back. I actually got a big old splinter in my hand from that one. And then I found this board. And I was super sad because there was so much wood there. I could have probably made $1,000 because it was like full length. Pieces.
It's like 10 feet, 10 foot, 2x10s.
And a little bit aged, like I don't know what they've used it for. So it's got scratch and character, and I just love it, love it, love it. So this all came from that one board, right?
Yes, all of that is from the one board, including these.
Including the little parts that we've got there. We're going to be making some trays because we know that people are starting to get ready for their holiday get-togethers, even if it's small this year because of social distancing, people are starting to prep for gifts to give, and a lot of times you can find scrap wood and you can really create something for not a lot of money. We're going to show you how to use milk paint to make food safe products because charcuterie boards are all the rage right now. They love to display all the cute things or cookies or whatever, so that's what we're going to do.
Let's get started.
Yeah.
This is leather. I'll talk about it in a minute. We're going to do something fun with that.
One of them, there's going to be a hack that I found on Williams Sonoma. It was $78 for their version, and I was like, oh no, oh no. We're not gonna do that.
Okay, so you're mixing.
I'm mixing paint. Can you move these two?
Yes.
So I'm gonna be using Summer Cottage, and I'm gonna water it down to make a blue grease green stain because I'm gonna be putting a transfer on this oval one. I saw an Anthropologie tray that I was kind of inspired by, and that's what I'm gonna make this one look like. So tell them what you did to prep this.
So what I did, I just cut the ends off of this. I drew an ovaly kind of shape on one side. I cut that out and then I just brought it over here, traced it, so it's fairly uniform. I mean, it's not perfect. Every time you cut something out or trace it, it's gonna be a little bit different, especially with a jigsaw, but it's close. So we just, and I left the ends just a little bit square, just, you know, interest or whatever, maybe me just not getting my oval right. So jigsaw on that. I found a Black & Decker jigsaw, I think. It's $29.99. I have almost the same one that I've had for 10, 15 years. Great to get you started if you want to get into practicing with a jigsaw.
So Amber says, who would throw that away? I don't know, Amber.
It was a ton of it.
It was a ton of good wood. I was like, oh man.
It was like lumber prices right now, literally, it was probably a $20, $25 board.
Not, I told Zeb, need to have a pile of where people can put usable wood that you could use for scraps or whatever. I told him, I said, even if we don't use it, I'll put it on the side of the road and be like free, because here, we do that all the time with our scraps.
I'm gonna scooch down this way so you can be more
centered.
Yeah, and work on your, have room to work on your project.
So I've just got Summer Cottage in here. This is Farmhouse Finishes paint. And I watered it way down, probably like 6 parts water to 1 part paint.
So I did sand this board before we started.
Well, you want to sand it to clean.
But it's got some knots, yeah, and it's got some knots and some dings and divots from whoever was using it or throwing it away. But that, it's smooth to touch. I would still go this way with your stain.
Yeah.
So that you don't get any of those raised fibers, and then we'll buff it again once you have some color.
I'm hoping that this is the color I want. I might have.
That's going to be very light. You had a lot of water.
Yeah, I think I need more paint.
So when mixing this for a stain, we usually go 1 part paint to about 10 parts water. I think Jamie has about 25 parts water to 1 part paint in this mix.
Are you sure about that?
She's going real light. I'm going to do something similar on this one.
I found this cup in the kitchen, so if this cup belongs to somebody that works for me, I'll replace it.
I'm gonna do more of like a whitewashed effect. I'm hoping that it'll look kind of bleached when I'm done. And I left my cup over there. So I'm just using Flower Sack. All the Sweet Pickens products are bio-certified food safe.
Hi, my sister Renee's on here. Hi, Renee.
So the paint, and then not the oil waxes, the hemp oil is bio-certified.
I need to, when the situation is over, get all my sisters up here. We'll go stay in a hotel and I'll do a craft weekend and we'll film it. All right, that's much better. So we're getting this blue-green stain on here. I think it's so fun to do colored stains. You still get the wood grain, but it also gives you a fun color to play off of. Now I will wind up doing a stain on the back too, but I'm not going to do it right now. So can you guys see that? It's like a greenish tone. I might dry it and do a second coat to really amp up the color.
Just so getting my mixing container ready here.
All right. We've started doing the floors at the farmhouse. They are a lot of work. So if anybody local would like a free lesson on how to use the floor nailer, I'm welcoming you to contact me and you can come by and I'll let you do a few rows of flooring. Cause I did 3 feet yesterday and it's like a full body workout. I could just offer personal training sessions and then just tell them, okay, now we're gonna use this tool. I feel like there's parts of my body that are achy and muscles I didn't know existed.
So I'm just guessing on my measurement. I might have to do like Jamie and add more. Did you show them close? That's a really cool.
I did, but I'm going to put a second coat on here.
Aged green color. It looks like one of those hutches that we got that was the paint was so worn off.
Like
you could
oxidized.
See the wood grain back through it.
Yeah, this is good.
It's probably from the early 1900s.
This is farmhouse finishes, so it won't chip. Milk paint wouldn't either though. Like on raw wood, it's not gonna chip.
Can I borrow one of your stirring forks?
I did bring some extras for you. So Zeb's starting plumbing. We have decided to go with the sheet enamel tub instead of the original clawfoot that came from the farmhouse. We will save that and use that as a planter.
It's a lot bigger, the tub that we're using.
It's longer and it's not as heavy. And I feel like on a second floor that's kind of a good thing. And I could actually help them get up the stairs. So the sheet enamel tub that's going in the bathroom it's an antique tub. I believe it was imported from Hungary, but actually not super expensive. I mean, if I were to sell it, it'd be expensive, but I got it from my picker and it was cheaper than buying a new tub. So we'll work on that this next week. We'll get the, the epoxy kit out and touch that up.
We're working on getting the four-way ready to go now that the outside is mostly done. There's a couple little places we got to do some touch-up paint, but...
Well, I'm actually okay with that because the flooring is kind of tedious and hard, so I thought, well, I'll do some flooring, and when I've had enough of that, I'll go out and do the other things that need to get done. Last night, I was up awake thinking about the front porch. We keep talking about we're going to put it off, but I'm like, oh, it would just be so pretty to get that done.
It would be pretty. It's time-wise, it's very consuming.
This is true, but it's gonna be top of the priority list once we actually live there is the porch. I don't care how old it is.
Oh, that's fine.
Because
on the south side of the house, so it'll be warm even if it's if it's sunshiny, it'll be fine.
We got a new channel member, Little Miss Mary Mary. Make sure you're hitting up community, not on an iPad and not on your phone, but on a computer, because then you can scroll back and you can find the last 45 days worth of printables as well as our last channel member live. Now, if you are a channel member, remember that this last week of October is our week off. We take off 1 week every quarter from our channel member and business coaching, and we're taking it off to work on the farmhouse. So we won't have any channel member videos or business coaching videos until the first and second week of November, and we'll let you guys know.
Okay, so I also needed more paint, but that's, you just work with your mixture till you get it the color you want it to be.
Part of the reason I'm not finishing the bottom is because there's some very fresh paint on the table and I'm going to have to sand the bottom.
Oh, are we going to have to sand that off?
Yeah, because it's getting all over. I need to seal this table so that way the paint doesn't stop coming off. I was thinking about just running a sander over and smoothing it out.
Well, it would definitely help it, yeah, just to sand it.
All right, I'm gonna get the heat gun out to dry this, and then I'll get started on my transfer.
The transfer, for the record, is probably food safe, but we're gonna seal it with top coat.
Yeah, we're not using hemp oil over it, so put food on it at your own risk. I wouldn't get, I mean, have you ever eaten food that was on your table? Because your table's
lacquered.
That's lacquered. As long as it's cured, it's fine. It's not like you're eating chips. Everything we use is all natural. What is going on here? Can you? I
got a niche on my nose.
Oh. There we go. I just have to. I bet you it's loose at the outlet.
Maybe.
Thanks, Robin. She says this color is pretty. This heat gun is definitely going. I just got to dry this off so I can put the transfer on it. So this is Summer Cottage. It's a really pretty teal color. I think that when you're doing patinas to look like rust, that if you do a watered down Summer Cottage with your Pennies from Heaven, you can get a really good rust patina. Just finished working at the food pantry and my reward is watching you live. Oh, Peggy, I love that. That's awesome.
Food pantries are amazing.
We have...
It's always, like, really hard work, but so rewarding.
Yeah, we have a place where they put together food backpacks for kids for over the weekends. And it's one of our favorite charities to donate to. And Eliza has worked there with her friend. It's called, like, something 509, I think. I can't remember the exact name. I'll have to look it up. This is not even hot. It's like a blow dryer, but it's blowing it.
Is it gonna work?
Oh, Sandy says, I would still put parchment paper on my board, even if it's food safe, to keep my board safe from getting stains from cured meats. That is a smart idea. And you can, like, if you use hemp oil on your boards and you feel like they need more, you can use hemp oil on a regular basis on your cutting boards and such to keep them prepped. I just want to make sure this is dry so that way the transfer sticks.
So I wiped a lot of my, like, color off right there.
This is so cool. I can't even tell you. I'm going to show you guys. It's like all down in the wood grain.
I'm going to need your blow dryer slash heat gun.
Blow dryer slash
heat gun. In a second here so that I can... Maybe I will...
Find the other heat gun?
No, I know where it's at. I think it's over.
Well, I'm going to be doing the transfer here in a minute so they can watch that.
I'm just gonna put this down so when I flip it, it doesn't get all the paint.
Renee says, good luck, we can't even FaceTime. My poor sisters are so patient. They like to FaceTime at night and I'm so tired, I'm like, I can't be on camera. I told them, like, you're gonna have to wait till the farmhouse is done. It is definitely crunch time, as far as that goes.
So I'm just taking these pieces of wood here, move that so you can see what I'm doing.
I'm gonna show them this real quick. So this is what it looks like dry. It'll darken a little bit when I seal it. And I'll let Zeb show you what he's doing. And I'm going to work on getting the transfer. I chose Flora Parisiensis. Is that, did I say it right? Is that?
No.
Parisiensis?
Parisiensis?
This one.
I don't know.
Just search Flora, F-L-O-R-A, at jamierayvintage.com and you'll find this. Donna says it's so springy. I agree. I mean, I guess it's weird because we're going into winter, but... I still decorate with the same colors no matter what time of year it is, so. I need, like, something to open.
Oh, I got some scissors right over here.
Thank you. Have any of you made your own stain out of black walnuts? We have not, but that is a good idea. Do we ever get back to that YouTuber that Caitlin?
Yeah, Caitlin messaged him.
We want to do a collab. I can't even remember his YouTube name, but he has over 1 million subs, and he does things like the old school method. So we wanted to find some antique methods of making paint and stains, so and then do a video. So that might be coming up in the new year. We're excited about that. All right, I need the scissors to cut this anyways.
Oh, well, there you go. I'm ready for
it. All right,
you.
Thank you.
Okay, so I just got this lined up, mostly even. I'm just feeling it with my hand here.
Oh, there it is.
And I countersunk these holes. Hopefully it doesn't split the wood.
Dawn and Eric Bowden from Refined and Whimsy said, love how you can see the wood grain. So.
Okay, now we do this side. This is going on the top. I thought it was going to be little feet on the bottom, and Jamie was like, no, it goes on the top. But then she showed me a picture and I was like, oh, now I see.
I got the idea early this morning while I couldn't sleep because Jack came in our room because he had a dream about scary aliens. And then I couldn't get back to sleep. All right, so I've just cut off pieces from this. And I'm going to use this on the edge.
Is that smooth enough? Are you sealing that? That's a little wet. I would probably dry that off a little more.
If you really want your paint and your sealer to be dry, so. It's like loose at the outlet, so I gotta shake it. Hey, Debbie's on here. She's coming this weekend. Excited to see
Debbie. Here, if you turn that one off, this one has a short cord, so you're gonna have to do it over the top. And not melt your transfer or your phone.
Don't want to melt this phone. Oh, that's better. Yeah, Debbie and Kenise are coming down to watch. The taping is a show called The Chosen. You can look it up. There's an app you can watch it on. It's a crowd-funded show, which means the people that watch it are the people that essentially pay to have it made. And they film it in Goshen, Utah. There's a studio that our church that we go to, the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, uses to film videos for our church. And The Chosen, while not made by our church, has rented that area to film their... Oh, this is drying so much faster now. To film The Chosen. So Debbie's coming to do that. And when she's done, her and Kenise are going to come to the farmhouse and work. And I think... Let's see if I can get Debbie to come to the shop.
You don't come to the farmhouse to visit. You come to the farmhouse to work.
Yep, Debbie and Kenise are going to be on our live Saturday night. I think we'll have to do it from the farmhouse at the bar.
That's fine.
So we have more space.
Maybe I'll turn the heater on because it's probably...
If we get the internet functioning well.
This weekend, it's getting down into the low 20s at night, and even it dips down below that on Sunday, I believe.
Debbie, bring your parka. It's gonna be cold this weekend.
It's trying to bring winter on. We'll probably have it'll probably warm up like maybe one more time into the 50s, and then we'll be like full on winter.
Okay. So probably best practice to seal underneath the before you put it over the top of this paint. But the milk paint is not quite as chalky, I guess, as the DIY, so it should be okay.
You've got it on there basically super thin.
But the problem is when you seal it, you really got to have that sealer dry. I don't know if you guys remember a few episodes ago, we did that cabinet with the roses on it and it wasn't quite dry and I was like literally on the table. It's like, you will submit to my will. Oh yeah, this is working good.
I'll try not to melt your thing.
So when I'm working on platters like this, I like to keep the design kind of around the edge, maybe a little top and bottom, but leave the center empty. So that way, whoever displays on it has a good frame, essentially, for what they're displaying.
So this, I think, is gonna work out. It's not, I wanted to go with like a real light, just kind of aged, almost bleached look on the wood. With this whitewash, I think we're gonna get there. I might have to do one more coat once I get it dry. I'll hold it up in a sec so you can see it with the wood grain. Did you show them yours?
Yeah. Sorry. I don't want to waste that little leaf there.
Can't waste the transfers. Ew.
Go around the edge with it. Getting there. So I'm gonna, you can layer transfers over the top of each other. So I'm gonna come back with this flower. Just kind of deciding how I want it laid out. This is the top of my piece here. Once you put it on there, you kind of got to commit. Oh, I'm not going to do this part. I don't need the curly cue.
Okay. So I think I'm going to do one more coat. But you can kind of see, and once I put the oil on, it'll reactivate that a little bit and blend it, because it's so thin, it's not gonna chip like a traditional milk paint would.
You could also, so this Flora transfer, if you have Apothecary, it goes really well with that. So if you wanted to create a similar look, again, the DIY products aren't necessarily bio-certified, so keep that in mind, but you could totally get a similar look with this transfer and watered down Apothecary.
So I don't know if you guys can see the difference there.
Or Farm Fresh.
This is no stain. This is the light.
Oh yeah, you can totally tell.
Kind of bleached, whitewash, aged look.
Was that just a mix of white DIY? No, it was...
This is Flower Sack and Sweet Pickens milk paint.
Or you could use Snow White and Farmhouse Finishes. We're doing both. These boards are going to be completely food safe because Sweet Pickens paint and hemp oil is bio certified. So it's good to use if you're worried about that. We used to use a different stain we carried that was called Real Stain, but that's no longer made. So we've started using the Sweet Pickens, and it works as good, if not better, and it's much cheaper too. So it just takes very little.
A sample would probably stain, maybe not in a lighter color, but if you had like a dark color like Lantern, a sample would stain a whole table.
Yeah. Like a tabletop, for sure. Like I'd probably mix up, I have so much stain here.
You have a lot over there.
Well, because I put too much water in my cup. I know better.
So on the charcuterie boards that we make, we actually just mix the milk paint directly with the hemp oil and put that on.
Yeah, we have it in a big jar.
It seals it and stains it all at once.
That's a 2-for-1. All right.
I'm going to go one more coat, and then I'm going to move on to another one, and we'll put some handles on it.
All right, I need to measure.
I think we're going to go green like Jamie's color there, because that turned out really good.
I'll show you guys this here in a bit. You really want to make sure that you're burnishing your transfer. Make sure there's no air bubbles, especially where this is raw wood. I'm just like making sure it's like down into the grain. And I might even sand it a little bit to kind of blend it in with the bottom. That's always a fun look. All right, so here's part of it. I'm getting there. I'm gonna work on the other side. I think I'm going to use this big portion over here. This is pretty luscious.
It's a luscious transfer.
It's luscious.
Okay, I'm going to take this outside and let it sit in the sun and dry because I think I want to stencil on it. And you can also stencil full strength milk paint and it's still food safe. Moment of silence while Jamie reads all the comments. She's very focused on her
Thanks,
craft
Lenora.
Today.
She said I look nice today.
Look nice
this
every day.
This is second day hair. Eliza's really like big on being on time. And she was...
I'm sorry.
Yeah,
sorry.
She gets that from you. I'm gonna use the bottom of this one.
Like when she says big on being on time, like on time for me is 10 minutes early.
So she was rushing me. I literally had like 5 minutes to wash my face.
On time for Jamie is if we get there 5 minutes after it starts, we'll be okay.
Here's the thing. I try to be on time because I value other people's time. Oops, I got that wet somehow. But I also learned to not freak out. It's not worth yelling at my kids for a few minutes. Because then everybody's grumpy and nobody's happy and it just, nobody wins. So.
The only one that, the only one of our kids that wasn't on board with being 10 minutes early with me was Harry. And he fought it to the last minute. I'll be right back. I'm going to go set this in the sun to dry.
I've chilled out on a lot of things that I used to be very fastidious about. Life's too short to be angry. All right. Here. Oh, Jane says she watched the sisters use the brick roller yesterday. I actually have a wall in my house that I want to use it on. I've talked to the IOD sisters about coming and collaborating with me, but if they don't make it, I'm still going to use it on that wall. It's in the mud room. It's the old exterior wall because we have some original exposed brick that'll be in the family room. But then we have like the original stucco, and I kind of want to go over the stucco with a brick roller. I think it would look cool. Sorry.
I'm thinking leather handles on this one. If you've been patiently waiting for the leather handles, they're coming.
Okay.
So this leather that I'm going to use is just... It's scraps. You can get it at most craft stores in like a bundle of scraps, and it comes in various colors, sizes. It's usually about $10-$15. And I used to have a bunch of it. This is all I've got left of these two pieces, but it's gonna work perfect for what we're doing today. And I don't know if you guys know, leather, accents, not and pulls and things is super in right now.
Joey says she's known for hemming her dress on the way to a party.
Sometimes you just got to get out the door. You got to get to the place.
She's running late, so she's like, that's why she's hemming
it. Oh.
If I knew how to hem a dress. I mean, I guess I could in a pinch. That's actually much better at sewing by hand than I am. I can use a machine.
It's been a long time.
My machine has not been functioning well.
Sewn by hand.
I don't like sewing anything with a pattern. It's too much effort.
She sticks with pillowcases.
I know. I know you guys are shocked by that, I'm sure.
Have you even shown them up close at all what you're doing?
Yeah.
You're making them guess at it.
I totally showed him that flower.
Nice.
I feel like you're not even paying attention to me.
I was gone.
Hey, is that water drinkable? I have a dry mouth.
Yes.
Okay, thanks. I just didn't know if you used it with anything. I use leather belts for handles. Usually pick them up at thrift stores for around $5.
Excellent. Smart. You can also find purses. I've done that with purses at thrift stores. They're super cheap, like usually around $5. Get a whole bunch of leather.
Yeah, we don't ever throw away leather. We don't use it all, but we have a friend of ours. His name is Jacob. He does cosplay. And so sometimes Zeb will save leather for him. He sews it, doesn't he?
Yeah, well, he does all kinds of fun stuff with it.
He's a sewing ninja.
All right.
Oh, this is cute. Jasmine said, I'm thinking about doing leather straps on some drawers. I have to do. Love it for accents. I've totally seen that. I've actually seen leather pulls, like where they make them into pulls. So very kind of high-end Williams Sonoma, Pottery Barn, Anthropology type look with the leather.
Restoration Hardware is my favorite. They go a little more industrial with their look.
It's kind of hard to go around the edges with this transfer, but
So we're just using paper towels. You could totally just use a rag if you weren't using multiple colors.
All socks and underwear work.
Maybe don't do any food safety stuff with old socks and underwear.
Well, if they're clean, bleach them first.
Yeah, whatever.
I mean,
just a thought.
Socks. Okay, I guess, yeah. You're a little better at like thinking about stuff like that. There's a knot here, so I gotta get this loud. All right, I'm totally gonna distress this before I seal it, but I'm almost done. What do you guys think?
Oh, you show them yours.
All right, so I've got this going on.
I was going to show them my wood grain.
That's cool.
And this is actually pretty thick. Jamie mixed this up quite a bit thicker.
Yeah, it just wasn't showing the way that I wanted it to.
Jane says she uses old socks.
I use old socks, yeah. We have a whole bag. When the kids match socks, they can't find them. They just bag them up and then put them in the garage. All right, did you have sandpaper over there? I need 220. I think there's some right there next to that white wax can on top of the milk paint container.
Okay.
Like three rows up, do you see it? Down by your like, yeah. If it's low, I gotta tell them where it's at because Zeb sees all the things up high. This is 150. I prefer 220, but it's all right, I'll just be soft. So you can totally stand over the top of transfers and it'll just go down into the wood grain.
All right, we have a couple of different pool options. We sell these at jrvhome.com. So here's the shell cut pool. I think I'm gonna go with this library card style pool.
Yeah, those are jrvhome.com. They range in price. Mostly they're $3.95. I think there might be one that's $4.95. Just look up hardware or pools at jrvhome.com. They're all cast iron. I use them in the farmhouse a ton.
So this one, the last one, I'm going to make you wait to watch me do the leather. Mostly I saw the pools here and I'm like, oh yeah, we're going to do pools on here.
I'm just going to go over this and make sure we don't have any more raised parts. I'll show it to you in a second so you guys can see.
The cool thing about these cool pools is that they come with screws. A lot of pools don't. And then you're like stuck looking for them at the hardware store, like what's going to match with this color and go well with it.
All right, so that's what it looks like with the distress. And you can see that it kind of blends the transfer in and makes it look less like a sticker and more like it's part of the piece. Oh, Alicia English just did leather pools. I have not watched her videos. That girl is like crazy pants doing her whole house. It's really fun. Okay, I'm going to seal this. I got a sealer. Do I have any big top? I might.
Is that already dry enough to seal over there?
Is it already dry enough? Might.
I just eyeballed those. You could easily measure. All right, that one is gonna get sealed, but I think it's done. Like, we'll just leave this like this. Yeah, a fun little tray. Okay.
Oh, that's not how that's supposed to go.
How's it supposed to go?
It's supposed to have, it has to have the lip on there.
I have the lip on the other one.
Oh, I want to, that's okay.
This is I only made one lip.
Okay. Then I would probably stencil something on that.
Yeah, I'm going to, but it's gotta get dry.
Sorry. Not that I'm bossy.
You are bossy.
I had a vision.
You are bossy, but it's okay.
I say please. And a smile. Can you open this for me?
Yep.
Yeah, usually I use 220. I used 150 today, so to go kind of gently. It got a little scratchy looking, but that's all right. I don't know if we have this shirt in the store, which I don't think we do. We might have a small left. It's been a long time. We do have some other animal prints, just not this one. And then this cardigan is in the shop too. I love black cardies.
Okay. What color do you want this one to be? This is going to have the leather straps.
I would do that one like a grayish brown color. That's like the one that they had at Williams-Sonoma was that color.
Okay, I think.
I'll see if I can find the one from Williams-Sonoma that kind of sparked this idea. And I saw a platter at Anthropologie that had flowers on it. That was similar to this, but it's definitely totally different color scheme. And it was probably porcelain.
I'm gonna go swipe a razor blade from Jean.
We have only about 100. So I'll probably do two coats of this on here. And then, you know, if you're gonna use it with food, which I totally would, I wouldn't worry about it. You can't like submerge this in the dishwasher. It's like a hand wash lightly kind of situation. I have to disclaim that because sometimes we're like, well, I scrubbed it and then I put an SOS pad on it. You never want to submerge wood anyways. All right, where's the heat gun? Yeah, so jrvhome.com is where you can pick up the hardware pools and our home decor. These will be listed on there tomorrow for the Stay at Home Shopping Network. That's where you get everything for home. So clothes, decor, things like that. If you want to get the paint and the transfers, we carry that on our DIY website, which is JamieRayVintage.com. That's where you get all the paint and products. We have so many things that we have two separate shipping teams, and it would be a holy nightmare to have it all in one. Plus, I just don't think shipping paint and clothing in the same box would be very good.
So normally I would probably like mark this out and use a metal straight edge, but I couldn't find one. So I've just got this razor blade here.
I'm going to be careful because I don't want to heat the transfer up and make it peel.
It's going to take a few passes.
Heat and transfers don't mix. Do not heat gun your project. Oop. I'm only doing this because I'm in a hurry.
All right, second pass made it through.
I'm gonna let that air dry. I'm not gonna push my luck and I'll do a second coat. Would DI wax be okay over milk paint? Yeah. I use DIY wax over any painted surface, it's fine. Big Top is not bio-certified, so I'm just clarifying that. It's all natural, what it's made with, I mean, you're not gonna ingest it, but I can't say that it's bio-certified. The hemp oil is, so just know that. To get something bio-certified, just so you guys know, is like, you have to go through the government.
It's a lot of effort.
The only reason that the milk paint is because the parent company is Old Fashioned Milk Paint. Sasha owns that now. They've been around since like the 70s for a long time. So
they had
an older company. Yeah, Big Top is gonna be harder than Liquid Patina. Liquid Patina is a softer finish. So I like to use Big Top on something that I know that's going to be washed. Like I use it on, I have used a top coat, like Sue Pickett's top coat on tables, but I use like Big Top on tables or nightstands that are going to get a lot of abuse, those kind of things. The nice thing about Big Top is I feel like it levels out pretty well and you don't get like a thick finish. So it's really forgiving for brushing it on. Sometimes you put sealers on stuff and it just looks awful.
Oh, I got that one on the first pass.
I would eat off a DIY paint.
Yeah, I would. I wouldn't even sweat it, but technically we can't tell you that.
Our attorneys say that we have to tell you it's not food safe.
Oops.
We can't claim that it's food safe right now. I'm not gonna put this over that transfer anymore. You don't want to put heat on it. I'll just do this. All right, this is almost done. I'm gonna do another coat on it, but I'll show it to you guys with the sealer. It adds a little bit of sheen to it.
Okay, now I have two leather straps.
So this platter's done. Yeah, Debbie's like, it probably could be, but red tape. Yup.
Okay, can you put a color of stain that you want on here, on this one? And I'm gonna go grab that other one and stencil on it.
Do you have dark, or do you need me to make it?
Might need you to make it. I bet you if you added some lantern to that.
You could make gray, would you get me some?
Yeah.
So I'm not off camera. While you're doing that, I'm just gonna put a second coat on here. When we're no longer live, I'm going to faux stain the bottom of this.
I have zinc, that'll probably get you kind of a brownish color.
You have what?
Zinc.
Yeah, zinc is good. Zinc is a dark, dark gray.
Okay, so do that one. I'm gonna go grab that other board outside so we can stencil it.
Okay. I don't know where to put this to dry. Hold on, guys. I'm gonna go off camera for just like 3 seconds. And I'm back. Ooh. Do we have a fork? All right, just a little bit more water. Rumi says, I need Jamie's tray. We'll get it up on JRV Home. Pretty quick. I gotta finish it today. So either today or tomorrow it'll be on the website. If these are popular and I find more wood, we might make some more.
Well, I have lots of scrap wood. This just happened to be the board from the tip.
I have to be in the mood, though.
Okay, show them the raw unstained, and this is with the flour sack. You can still, it's still picking up the wood grain pretty well. You can see where it's not quite dry over here in the corners.
Do you want to give me the paper towels?
Yes.
I don't know why my words are losing me today. I think
it's because you've had 2 nights of no sleep.
Yeah, it's going to be a real fun
woke
day.
Up at like 3 yesterday and couldn't go back to sleep. And then about the same time today.
About 4 today before Jack came in. So this is going to be a gray stain.
All right. Stencil on this. We have, oh man, it's just, maybe I will put it on that.
Yeah, Sweet Pickens top coat is more matte, and I would say Big Top is satin. I wouldn't call it semi-gloss.
So I messed up.
What?
The stencil is just a little bit too large to go in between.
Okay, well what about that, not that wild and the, and All Things Give Thanks. It's over there. Sorry. Yeah. You could just do give thanks.
Where over here?
Over here, it's on the top of the. Oh. Am I sounding, no, I'm not sick. I'm just tired if I sound hoarse. And I haven't drank enough water yet. Usually I drink like 36 ounces by now.
I can fit the whole and All Things Give Thanks on here.
Remy says, LOL, Jamie, I finally finished my niece's t-shirt quilt when I got in the mood. You know what? I used to have to do custom work for people, and I had time frames when it came to creativity and creating. I don't do that anymore. So if you want something I make, you gotta get it while I have it, because who knows when I'm going to feel like doing it again. I just show you how, that way you can...
I need you to drink all that water.
Oh. For you, I will. What are you using that for?
To mix up
some hemp oil?
I might just do zinc.
Oh, well, you probably needed some of that water.
Well, I'll get more. I just didn't want to spill it all over while
you were cutting it?
Yeah.
This isn't quite the color of the one. This is more gray stained, but that's okay. I think this will match really well with the color of the leather. Can you guys see that grayish stain? If you want it darker, just use more paint or do multiple coats of stain, which is maybe what I'm gonna do.
So when I'm stenciling, I like to mix the milk paint up a little on the thick side. We're just using any and all containers here today.
It's being green. It's Waste Not Wednesday, man. Is this my water cup?
No.
I'm like...
It didn't have ice in it.
It did have ice?
Didn't.
Oh no, mine didn't.
So maybe
have ice.
It was from yesterday.
It was my yesterday's water cup that I brought. I love foam cups, but I try to reuse them because they're, you know, not green. So so I use them till they die. They're not single use for me. Oh, you could make a laptop tray. That would be cool.
Oh, yeah. Those are super handy because if you've ever had to be like sitting down with a laptop on your lap, it gets really hot really fast. And sometimes they'll overheat. At least mine always do because I'm usually running something like Photoshop or Premiere Pro or something. Some CAD program for the CNC.
Another coat on the top.
I think that's gonna be enough. I might mix it up even more with my brush. Just gonna get it down here on the mat so that I can offload.
Shop towels might be better for this.
Yes.
Although they're fuzzy.
They can be.
They can be fuzzy. I'm getting rollies, but we'll get those off there. What it is we're just super behind and I need to wash a bunch of shop cloths for the shop. Okay, doing two coats to make this a little bit darker.
I could swirl here, but I haven't tried it with the milk paint, so I'm gonna dab.
Yeah, milk paint's a little thinner. You can make it thicker.
I did try to make it thicker, but I don't know that I was, I made it about regular.
Oh. Oops, don't put that. I'm just using zinc mixed with flour sack to make a gray stain. And then I'll use hemp oil.
So if you see it in certain lights, zinc is like a dark gray color, but I feel like it looks almost greenish sometimes too.
I don't see the green, so.
Watch when you hold it up. You won't be able to unsee it.
Can milk paint wash?
Can you wash this, like wash it off after having food on it?
Cloth.
I wouldn't put it in the dishwasher or completely submerge it, but just like washing a cutting board.
I haven't decided if I'm going to put handles on the one that I did. I don't think I will.
I don't think yours needs handles. I think the oval and the transfer give it enough interest.
So mine will be more expensive because I've used a transfer on it, and they are like $30 a transfer, so I used about half of it, so it's about $15 worth of transfer. So I'll probably sell that one for probably somewhere around $39.95. I'll make sure when you guys are selling things and you use products on them that you're getting your value out of it. Otherwise, it doesn't make it worth it.
Alright, there's the stencil. This stencil actually has like a big kind of fall style wreath on it, but I just used the words.
I like that.
Should I put handles up here?
Yeah, that was the plan.
Do we want to use more cup pulls or do we want to try for the shells?
I wanted to use the mercantile pulls on this. So those ones, yeah.
These ones?
Yeah.
They're called mercantile pulls?
Yeah.
They look like seashells to me.
Seashells? Well, but on the website they're called mercantile pulls, like an old mercantile store. So I'm just sanding this a little bit, making sure that there's no splinters, and also bringing out some of that wood grain to add some variation in tone. And I'm sorry if you have a hard time listening to the sander.
ASMR.
ASMR. I missed a spot on the bottom here. I'll get that when I do the bottom.
I did not pre-drill these holes, so hopefully this works out okay.
The nails are pretty small. All right, so there's this one. Where's that hemp oil? Time with prices. You know what? I priced them according to what the wood would be worth new, my time. But yeah, they're going to be somewhere
products used
between $40 and $50 depending on what you use. Because, you know, the pools are $3.95 a piece. So that adds a little bit of value to it.
We got lucky this time and found some at the tip.
The tip, yeah.
But next time we might just have to go down to the hardware store and buy like a $25 board.
Jamie says, are you ever going to make stovetop covers for the whole top of your stove? No.
You know why not? Jamie doesn't like them.
I don't like them. I see their need if you have a small kitchen. But I just think it's weird. I don't know. It's not my jam. And also, people here don't really buy them. And they're huge, so they would be really expensive to ship. Lolly says she agrees. Okay. I don't want to hurt anybody's feelings. I think that they're cool and useful, especially if you have like a small RV or something. I definitely would have one in that case just for like useful purposes. But what's the tip? The tip is the dump. It's what they call the dump in England. We watch, what's that show that we watch?
Something for nothing. I don't know what it is. I think that's what it's called.
So
it's on the BBC.
Hemp oil really enriches the grain color, and it did help that I sanded through the stain to bring out some of the original wood, so I'll show you that.
I'm also going to sand this stencil just lightly because it's looking a little too crisp.
And you do want to, if you wash this, you know, like wipe it down after use, make sure you're reapplying some sort of food safe oil on it. Oh, they call it the tip in Australia too.
Oh, nice. I watched Tarnia from Carts and Millie. I watched her new video this morning using some JRB stencils.
Yeah.
And she said she was flat out like a lizard drinking, and she'd been talking about that. I'm like, what does that even mean? And she used it in the video, and now I completely understand.
I think we were talking about it in business coaching.
Yeah.
Because I said busier than a one-armed paper hanger.
Yeah.
And Deb's like, what's that?
I didn't know what a paper hanger was.
Wallpaper,
like,
for somebody that does wallpaper.
Like, who hangs wallpaper anymore?
Yeah, we do. We're going to have to do some wall, drywall. Oh, this has got a little transfer on the table on it. Sure. Alright, I'm going to show you guys this here in a second. I would do a couple coats, let it dry. Drinking like a lizard, what?
Flat out like a lizard drinking.
Oh, okay. What does that mean?
That basically like a cat on a tin roof.
They're busy.
She's right. Super busy. All right, I am going to also oil this. Is this the, that doesn't look good.
I'm going to dry the oil a little bit. This one you can put the, oil isn't really something you can dry like this, but it does work a little bit. All right, I'm going
to
let you
put the leather straps
on
there?
And I will oil this.
Okay.
Oh, don't let me forget, we've got to do the bottom of that one.
Yeah, bottoms of all of
these. I love this with the ledge on it. I think we might have to do this for the green one that you did. I just feel like this makes it look more.
Well, it'd be easy to add on there. I just didn't have any more of these pieces cut because it's like if you've got table saw skills, it's like I'm like at level 4 and this is like a level 8 skill, and it was difficult to get them this narrow, not have the wood split, and cut them down the middle without having kickback. That's the trick. It wants to kick back really bad.
Or you could just buy a 1x10 if you were buying.
Well,
one.
I had this and it's waste not Wednesday.
I'm just saying this is what we had, but I'm saying you could.
So I'm just going to use the edge of my razor knife here, poke a little hole for the... screw to go down in.
And I definitely wouldn't do this with a 2-inch thick wood because it's just too thick.
Do we have any screws over there that are small?
Screws that are small.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. You can check the fasteners box over there. Yeah, we actually have a video on how to separate pallet wood pretty easy. It's an old video, but
we've got the information's good.
Yeah. But be careful though, because pallet wood, you never know like what it's going to treat with.
Pallet wood a lot of times is treated.
Yeah, you don't want to put your food on pallet wood. I mean, I guess if you sealed it. I've known people to use it for tables and stuff. So this one we're not going to do anything to it because we want kind of what am I looking for? Like a chic look. So it's just going to be very simple. Although, Zeb, did you already hemp oil this?
I haven't.
Okay.
That was your hemp oil job.
Okay. Well, that's okay. I'm just going to get some more stain on the side. I missed it. Yeah, this totally looks like lime washed wood here. This is good. Vintage Vibe says she really likes the poles. Me too. I like it. That's why we carry poles at JRV Home, because I got tired of what options they had. And every time I go to Hobby Lobby, they have like 5 poles.
And we need like
12. I'm doing a dresser. I can't just use 5 poles. I think we had like, oh, we do need to take, Caitlin, if you're watching, would you take out
we have
4 of these poles, the mercantile poles, out of stock?
We have these.
Oh.
But I don't have screws to go under them, so I'm just going to try and see if they'll hold on. If not, we'll use screws.
You can always get small screws later.
But these are essentially upholstery brads. They're called decorative tacks.
Thanks, Caitlin.
On here.
Oh, and the apothecary card catalog pulls. We need to take 2 of those out, too. We were kind of in a hurry before we went live.
Tacks, I think that's going to look good with the color of the board and the brown mother.
Lolly says that the tacks will look good.
Yeah, I think they're going to look better than screws. Screws would have given it like a nice industrial vibe, but
in all things, good things. So I think the green one, we're going to go ahead and do this to that too, because I just think it adds a little extra to the tray. And you don't have to use these for food. This would be so dang cute on a coffee table.
I'm gonna smash my fingers here.
Or you can also hang it on a wall, or you could sit it up like this because it's well, I guess if your surface was flat and not covered in paint, you could totally stand it up for display. Yes, the mercantile cup pull, 4 of these and 2 of the card catalog pulls. I don't know exactly what they're called. If you search hardware, Caitlin, you'll be able to find them. Thanks, Lolly's on it. Are you gonna finish the bottom? Yes. Well, we're not live. I'm going to put down a drop cloth on here so I don't get any paint transfer from the table, and I will finish the bottom. The bottom on these is just gonna get sanded and hemp oiled. The green ones I might stain green, so that one's done. So this is hemp oil, Vintage Vibes. So this is Sweet Pickens hemp oil. This is a sample size that you've seen us using today, but we also carry a larger size.
Sorry, it's getting aggressive.
You're going to use it a lot by the big size, but if you've just got a few projects, you can see obviously that a sample goes a long way. I got to make sure to get this in the water.
Uh-oh.
Because if you leave the big top, it will dry hard. Oh, you're doing it on the top.
Where did you?
The picture had it on the side.
Oh, like I didn't have enough leather to strap it over to the side.
Oh, okay.
We
were out of scraps. Let me find the Williams Sonoma tray. Let's see if I can even find it. It showed up in my, like, you know how Facebook listens to you? That's where it showed up, leather. Now I won't be able to find it. Is that on Pinterest? I should really screenshot stuff. Well, darn. If I find it, I'll share it.
It looks just like this board.
Yeah. Theirs was like a darker brown, and they put their straps on the side. I like the straps on top, too.
I have a plan.
You're a man with a plan? All right, we're almost done here. We'll show you all the boards that we got done today.
So much better.
Sorry, it's always loud on Waste Not Wednesday.
We do the using of the tools in real time.
Would you stencil before adding the leather handles? If you were going to stencil before or after, I mean, it's fine. Just don't get paint on.
The thing is, if you're going to do the hemp oil, you don't want to get the hemp oil all over your leather.
Yeah, I agree.
I mean, it'd be like conditioning it, but it might not ever try out for a while.
Lynn says she'd oil the leather straps too.
Yeah, you could.
You could do that.
It's like oil in a shoe, conditioning a shoe, or like an apron, like a leather work apron. All right.
Yeah, I think that'll totally hold it.
Yeah, it holds it.
It's not
good.
Going anywhere. That's like totally industrial farmhouse. So for the men in your life or somebody who just likes industrial farmhouse, but it's a little bit more of a masculine look and I like it.
I think it would be really cool with like you just decorating it up how you do. It would tone back the leather.
For sure. I love that. I love the light colored leather with the gray. It's a really good look. Here's this one, and then we'll show you.
I think you're right. This does need
that. This is looking a little sad. So we'll take this home. We'll put the little margins on the side and put these above it. And I might even whitewash it a little just to kind of tone that green down.
You can actually slip like cards in here so you could do something fun.
Yeah. Very farmhouse. And then you want to show it's over there. Oh. That way are all non for
like it's good. All right, so we're back, kind of. It must be on YouTube's end. It's having trouble right here at the end of the stream. Anyway, Jamie Ray Vintage Home and jamierayvintage.com.
Yeah, JRV Home stuff. For the pools and the clothes and where we're going to have these listed when they're complete. jamierayvintage.com for the paint and products. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to Jamie Ray Vintage for more.
DIY.
Bye, guys. Love you. Have a good Wednesday. Go get some junk from the tip, if it's allowed.
If it's allowed. Don't get kicked out.